She got the pupils to experience their skills and talents on ground and encouraged them to do so. She was closely associated with the Tamil Literary Association of Tamil Nadu. In absence, she was visited a few months back. Their sister was there, and she was there to receive the felicitation. Gift was given by the good lords of 20 colleges who were in the Tamil Literary Association. But just a few months ago. Is it the Abrahams has had a share of burden to carry in this world, and in which she bothered his day. She faced the difficulties bravely, as you are all know, and all know. She has spent a full life of scriptures and a loyal service, humility and courage. Mrs. Abrahams will always be remembered by those who knew her with attitude, respect and affection. We thank and praise God for all Mrs. Abraham was able to do in her lifetime, and also giving us the privilege of knowing and associating with her. I wish to extend my heartfelt condolences to her daughter, whom she loved, and she was in attendance, and ever she went out. And today I'm so happy to see her again. And her loving sisters and her loving family. And the other members of the family will always remember that they are all here today, and they will say thank God for the life of a great lady. As I end my humble tribute to her, I say Trinity will always be there. Trinity will always be there for the family, and we as Trinitarians will in every way respect the teacher who was fond of her own children in school. And may she rest in peace, and may light of her children shine upon her. We pray for the family, and let us today rejoice that she is in a happier place, and may God bless you all and God bless the family. Thank you.
I take this opportunity to say again thank you to to our beloved incarnation. Behind every life saved, behind every city built, behind every step forward of the society, there was a teacher. Nurturing him, encouraging him to pursue what it was they truly wanted, and sometimes conscious too. Mrs. Abraham was my grade 1 class teacher. And our assistant class teacher, she's also here. We were the last batch of Mrs. Abraham's. As a class teacher, she was there. She was our class teacher in 1996. And I'm really proud to say that I was the first student in our class to be caned by her. I remember the reason, I know the reason, but I don't want to disclose it because my son's grade 1 teacher is also here. So I don't want to disclose that. She was the second one to hit me after my mother. She carried me, she cared for us like a mother, like our own mother. Thank you very much, teacher, for that. All the times we were annoyed and still, she never failed to enlighten us for developing our skills, encouraging us not to be afraid to try, and promoting us to be good people. From our class, there's a research scientist, there are a few doctors, there are a few lawyers, masters, bachelors, teachers, engineers. She was the one who taught us Ana Bhavana. So we are really grateful for her. And thank you very much. I thank God for introducing us to her in our lives. She was a good friend of my mother also. We had some hard times. She was there with us, supporting us. We went to the same church and shared the same family. Words will never be enough to compensate everything she did for us. So we appreciate you so much and we are lucky to have you as our teacher. Thank you very much for your teacher. We love you and miss you. These words are on behalf of my classmates. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Lee and Mrs. Travis. Thanks for joining us. Loving words about the love that he had given to the speaker. Now, we have heard the words of the great people of the now let us hear the words from the scripture, the anointed son of the people of the Christus.
Psalm 32, verse 1 to 2. Sing joyfully to the Lord, you righteous. It is fitting for the upright to praise Him. Praise the Lord with the harp. Make music to Him on the ten-string lyre. Sing to Him a new song. Play skillfully with sharp joy. For the word of the Lord is right and true. He is faithful in all He does. The Lord loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of His unfailing love. By the word of the Lord will the heavens gain, their starry host by the breath of His mouth. He gathers the waters of the sea into jars. He puts the deep into storehouses. Let all the earth fear the Lord. Let all the people of the world fear Him. For He spoke, He came to be. He commanded, and was swift firm. The Lord foils the plans of the nations. He thwarts the purposes of the peoples. The plans of the Lord stand. known as vision. Therefore, he saw faith that it might be according to grace, so that the promise might be sure for all to see, not only to those who are of the law, but also to those who are of the faith of Abraham, who is the father of us all. As it is written, I have made him a father of many nations. In the presence of him, only believe. So all of which life, life will live, and cause those things which do not exist as though they did. Who contrary to hope, in what believe, so that he became the father of many nations, according to what was spoken. So shall the descendants be. And not being weak in faith, he did not consider his own body, or he did, since he was about 100 years old, and the deadness of Sarah's womb. He did not waver at the promise of God through the unbelief, but was strengthened in faith, giving glory to God. And he was fully convinced that what he was promised, he was also able to perform. And therefore he was accounted to him for righteousness. Now it was not written for his sake alone that it was imputed to him, but also for us. It should be imputed to us who believe in him, who raised up Jesus our Lord from the dead. We have given up because of our offenses, and was raised because of our justification. This is the word of God.
Thank you. verse 9. As Jesus went on from there, he saw a man named Matthew sitting at the tax collector's booth. "Follow me," he told him. And Matthew got up and followed him. While Jesus was having dinner at Matthew's house, many tax collectors and sinners came and ate with him and his disciples. When the Pharisees saw this, they asked his disciples, "Why does your teacher eat with tax collectors and sinners?" On hearing this, Jesus said, "It is not the healthy who need a doctor, but the sick. But go and learn what this means. I desire mercy, not sacrifice. For I have not come to call righteous, but sinners." Reading verses 18 to 26. While he was saying this, a synagogue leader came and went before him and said, "My daughter has just died. But come and put your hand on her and she will live." Jesus got up and went with him, and so did his disciples. Just then a woman who had been subject to bleeding for 10 years came up behind him and touched the edge of his cloak. She said to herself, "If I only touch his cloak, I will be healed." Jesus turned and saw her. "Take heart, daughter," he said. "Your faith has healed you," and the woman was healed at this moment. When Jesus entered the synagogue leader's house and saw the noisy crowd and people playing pipes, he said, With Jesus came grace. With Jesus came love and forgiveness. With Jesus came understanding and compassion. With Jesus came new life and life in abundance. Dear brothers and sisters, what is remarkable about this third stage, the stage where Jesus takes control, we see at the very beginning of when we follow the full gospel, Matthew is called by Jesus to serve. Here, Matthew is obedient and he follows Jesus. Matthew is known as a sinner because he was a tax collector. Jesus goes with Matthew and has a meal with the sinners. We see by law, Jesus should not have had a meal with the sinners, but his love and compassion led him to do that. Then, as we go on to the second part, here again we find there are two instances where the leader of the synagogue, whose daughter had passed away, he has faith in Jesus and he goes to Jesus and he says, "My daughter is no more." And Jesus obliges in going to see his daughter. At the same time, while Jesus is traveling, there is this woman with a 12-year-old illness, a painful illness. Her faith leads her to go and touch the robes of Jesus. And what happens? That faith not only restores her health, but also restores her place in society. So when we consider all these events, we have one thing to keep in mind. It is our faith. It's not just blind faith. Now we tend in Sunday school, we tend to say, okay, you want something? Go and pray and have faith that Jesus will give it to you. It's not this mind faith that we are talking about. It is the faith in action. The faith that passes all problems in our life. The faith that can walk, look at Jesus' face and walk on the water. The faith that can go and touch his robe. The faith that believes that when we believe a mountain will be moved, that it will be moved. Dear brothers and sisters, this faith does not come by just knowing, but it comes through a deep understanding which develops through our relationship with God. As we walk with him, as we study his word, as we understand how God worked in the Old Testament and how he continues to move among us through Jesus and the Holy Spirit in the New Testament. The faith we have, dear brothers and sisters, is not just a faith of word. It is a living faith. It is a faith that we all have been called to be priests and apostles. It is a faith that when we cry to the Lord and say, "Oh Lord, hear us," the Lord will definitely hear us. We do not need to go to a third person for the Lord to touch us. It is a faith that will allow us to kiss the leper. It is the faith that will allow us or give us the strength to meet all circumstances, to go out and help every person irrespective of any challenges we meet. Dear brothers and sisters, that is the faith we have been called to. And in that faith, there is righteousness. And in that righteousness, there is oneness with God. And in that oneness with God, God's kingdom is established on earth.
together with us. So, my dear brothers and sisters, where do we stand now? Do we need to go from pillar to post, looking for people to pray for us, looking for others to give us answers to our problems? When our answer is there within us, because the Holy Spirit is within us. Let us understand where we stand in our faith, because the Lord has called us to be living in our faith, be apostles of our God's kingdom, to carry His love and compassion to one another. Especially today, as we heard loving words spoken about our dear, I would call her Auntie Shiro. We understand that Auntie Shiro, in her way, according to her understanding, she has done her best to fulfill what God had called her to do. We see how compassionate and loving she has been as a teacher. I know it's not an easy task. At the moment, I will make one teacher. It's not easy having around 50 children with different needs. But we hear what a loving teacher she has been. Now these qualities can come only from one source, and that is the love of Christ that is within us. So dear brothers and sisters, once again, I would like to call upon you. Search your heart. See where you are failing. Concentrate on establishing that faith in God. Faith and obedience go together to fulfill God's will in our lives and in the lives of one another. May the Lord grant us grace to achieve what He wants us to achieve.
Pouring God's love into her so that it has many. Let's pray for her family. Pray for her loved ones and all those of us who she's been her loss. Let's pray for God's sure assurance. Meet again, and then knowing that she is in a state of freedom and free from all bondages. Let us see God's guidance as we have to stay the community, continues our pilgrimage, following. children starve. She comes to her love and care. Pray for her membership, the local parish. Pray for all activities, inspiration, and the dedicated work she put in. Pray for what she was able to accomplish as a person and as a team. And I spent to giving her all those who were nurtured by her and also upheld by the church and the college. And one of the places of service she made there her vocation and vocational activity to. Oh Lord, hear our prayer.
And in our prayer,
especially remember the words of the message we heard. For the ministry of inclusion and integration of the church. Pray for Christian communities who have now entered into ordinary time in Christian calendar. Pray for spiritual growth of each and every person, each and every family member of the wider church. Pray for all activities and programs planned towards this end. Spending time to God, a Christian weakness and common privilege. O Lord, hear our prayer. We can remember the sufferings of the world, our country, and in our local neighborhoods, and for those who still suffer due to hostility, unemployment, stresses and frustrations of current day, people also lack medicines, especially our own children and youth and other vulnerable groups whose voices are not heard and who are not seen, but they are being against us. Ask God to guide us to when you are possible, in which you are possible, to help those who need God's love. At this time, just also pray for many others who have requested their prayers from us. Pray individually for the life and interests of the saved. Pray for our families and also offer our personal devotions as we can work for this wonderful life and as we remember we are called to act in a similar way and also to give God thanks for the gift of life. O Lord, hear our prayers.
Peace to your kingdom, and grant that we and all your servants, being strengthened together in eternal fellowship of the Holy Spirit, may we join before your Son is coming again to glory His majesty, even Jesus Christ, our Holy Spirit.
Come on, Lord Jesus.
Please thank for the teaching of us. Jesus said, blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. The Lord be with you. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. It is actually a sign of peace, one with another. By making offerings to the Lord, let us sing in number 408. 408.
Thank you.
children of God, Jesus Christ, and sacrifice to us, and ever and great grateful to
all the very night that he was betrayed to suffer and make the cause of us to us, the Lord Jesus, through bread, and very natural thanks to you, Almighty Father, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same manner after supper, he took the cup also, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink all of you from this, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
And so, Father, we present this bread and cup in communion with your whole church. In fellowship, disappearing all the saints and union with all creation, we celebrate your Son's death and victory, giving thanks for all that Christ has done for us. For we are asked for all that lies ahead, as we receive the benefits of Christ's life, death, resurrection, and ascension in glory, and we eagerly wait for the heavenly banquet after Christ's coming. And we entreat you, most merciful God, to hear us and send your Holy Spirit. Now, on this and all your gifts, that they may be blessed and held by the life-giving power, giving for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son. To the end that we receive the same may be sanctified and filled with your grace and your mercy. And so this is our sacrifice of praise and thanks to you. May us our body in Jesus Christ, our Lord. By whom and with whom and in whom, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all that glory be to your Almighty Father, world without end. Amen. To be without the bread which we pray, is the sharing of the body of Christ.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you. The gifts of God for the people of God. Give thanks to the Lord for all his gracious, all his mercy. Let us meet in prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, you have conquered death and removed sin forever. We thank you for every special memory of our loved ones and for all the love that we share during those years we enjoy together. We thank you that now all the trials and weaknesses of this earthly life are ended. May we have grace to say, the Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We pray in the name of Jesus, who died for us and rose again. Amen. Say the thanks we pray together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us the body and blood of your Son. Holy Spirit, rest with him and abide with him this morning in all of this.